Hello and welcome to another special video review. And tonight I'm gonna be reviewing the police combiners. The whole team is called like Swat, Transformers, Shock Attack, Alloy, Deformation, City Defense. Basically, it's a they named him like City Defensor, which is the technically it's not at all Defensor at all. It's just a whole new combiners. Like the at first they came like they called themselves like the Trans Truck, which were a bunch of construct vehicle that combines into a Gestalt robot. And then there were the Trans Jets, which I have right here, which a bunch of jets and helicopter combining into a giant robot. Then they made the Trans Blasters, which are like five combining nerve gun that transform into robots and combine into a giant robots. And then they made the fire trucks, fire rescue combining team. Like even though it's all a different company, these guys are made by Rangda. I don't know, it's called Rangda. They have extreme similarities with joints and transformation to the Weihang fire truck rescue team. It's amazing the resemblance. So I'm guessing it's the same designer or same production team who just sold different molds to different company and Rangda bought these guys. So yeah, first of all, they all comes with the their instructions. And seriously, if you're at least half as good into Transformers, I'd say just throw these away. They are garbage. Lots of the transformation doesn't even make sense, and especially for combining the Gestalt mode, they have it all wrong. I mean, like, I'm just gonna show it to you later, but there's a lot of mistakes in these. So yeah, on one side you have like for this one is like the bike, and on that side you have transformation from the bike to the robot, and the other side for all of the other ones is like the Gestalt mode, all of them preparing them into Gestalt mode. So yeah, it's nothing much and they suck so bad. So yeah, here we have the whole team, and I know I shouldn't have done it, but I use Google Translate to translate all of their names from Chinese characters, because I can't read Chinese. I'm sorry, but so I just scan all of their names in Google Translator, and by God, they have weird names. I'm sure it's just lost in translation, but one of them like has the best name ever. And all right, so let's just start with the bike right here. This one is called Phantom Pioneer, which is actually okay for a name. And I gotta mention also, all of them have a lot of diecast, and the bike is pretty much the only one that doesn't have a lot of diecast in it. Pretty much the least diecast one. And this one, all of the seat, which is already arms, and the gas tank are in diecast. All the rest is plastic, but still pretty cool. He has a kickstand, stands pretty well. Yeah. Can't see it much. And yeah, right here there's a the wheel does pivot, but that's because I'm the one who forced it trying to transform it, and it's not that bad. It's just screws inside. I can just tie those up a little bit better, but just be in mind, like, these doesn't move. They can if you loosen the screws, but they shouldn't. So yeah, just keep this in mind. And yeah, there's nice detail. The chain, the motorbike chain is painted silver, which is a nice touch. And otherwise, there's not much to it. The handle are hard plastic, not in the usually they're like soft rubbery thing. Now they're in the hard plastic, so it's kind of nice. I don't like the soft rubber one. Gimmick. So, transformation. First off, you want to pull the legs down, and technically they're pegged in together, but they don't hold too much. And then you pull like this. It's kind of hard, but it works. So then you spread the legs. You can bend the knee a little bit, and then you open up. Well, the satchel, bag on side, they rotate down, and you can flip the toes open. Do this on the other side. So flip these down and flip the toes, and now we have the legs done, which kind of make a weird bear walk mode. Alright. Next up with the arms, pretty simple. Spread them apart, pull them just to unlock them, and then you want to lift the tank. It doesn't go higher, too much higher, just as high as that. And then you rotate the arms out like this, and then you can close the tank again. Next up, you want to pull the head like this and just flip it around. And the endo bar, you can, if you want, just place it back like this. Kind of makes them like frills or something. Now, for the shoulder, you can see right here there is the joint. You want to rotate the arms back like this. Same thing for the other side. Rotate back and move the arms down. And then you just have to wiggle those like this. And now we have Phantom Pioneer all transformed, which is actually pretty nice. He does suffer from loose ball joints in the waist. It's not that bad. Nothing that glue or some sort of coating just gonna fix it. It's really easy. He does have knee articulation about like 45 degrees, which is really tight. And he's got like a huge tilt for the ankle and a ball joint in it. And it rotates, and the toes pivot. So yeah, as for the arms, he's got like a rotation joint right here, and a ball joint, and another ball joint. Oh, and forgot the thumb right here. You can move it around. The hand does pivot, not that much, but yeah. Open the thumb on the other side. And as for the head, it's only a ball joint, so it's kind of limited with the handlebar, which can move it a little bit and gives him much bigger rotation joint, but it still gets injured by the cockpit or the front of the vehicle, the front of the bike. But it's still a nice, you can see like a nice detail in the head right here. No light wiping, I don't mind, but yeah, it's nice golden. There's lots of nice, you can't really pick it up, but there's light, nice silvery golden details in the mouthpiece. So yeah, Phantom Pioneer done. Let's go with the car now. It's a nice Mustang looking police car, and this one is called Speed Lightning from Google Translation. And he's not that bad. The car looks pretty nice. For some odd reason, the police lights flip down, and I don't know why. It's not part of the robot transformation, and it's not part of the gestalt transformation, so I don't know. But this guy's transformation is actually pretty damn cool. I was really impressed. For this guy, all of the side door and window is die-cast. All of the back is die-cast. The bumper is plastic, but like all of the side door and back right here is diecast, and the not the hood. Yeah, that's it. As for transformation, you pull the hood out and you pull the back out. Next up, you want to raise the roof, which flips like this, and there's some nice detail inside of the roof, like lines and electric stuff happening. And what you want to do next is pull the side doors out like this. Pull the side doors like this. There's a mid-automatic peg right here that pegs inside of the fender wing or whatever, not a car frame. And next you want to flip the whole hood down like this. And you can see right here, this is the chest plate. And what you want to do is that peg right here will clip in that. So you just flip it all the way around and clip it in, which is actually pretty darn nice. Next up, you want to flip the arms down. Flip the arms down. And as for the leg, you want to open up the back bumper and flip the legs down like this. As for the waist, it's kind of floppy. You just want to flip it down like this, which make it much more solid. And then you want to flip the legs like this. And you come for the toe, you flip the door like this and you pull it back. So you just flip the door open and pull it back. And then you need some fingernails, or you need to flip the toes out. I was kind of having trouble, but yeah. Sometimes they come out easy and the other ones just doesn't want. Alright, like this. So now we have Speed Lightning all done. And he is actually pretty damn cool. Now, he does have a weird backpack like this, and it doesn't really go too far. It's kind of weird, but you know, still looks nice. And if it's raining, you can always give him a hood. So yeah, he is pretty nice. The head is on a swivel, and it's a nice detailed head. Again, no light piping, which I don't mind at all. The arms is on a ball joint and a swivel that goes up and down. There's a swivel at the upper arm and a double elbow. What do you ears? There's nothing on that wrist, which is a normal hand. On the other hand is a cannon. Again, as for the there's no waist swivel. There is ball joint legs. Again, a little bit loose. This one can actually pose a little bit more, but yeah, the joints is, well, I can always like put some burnish or some glue on it to make it more solid. It's not a real big deal. Then we have like the swivel there, and the knee. If you want knee articulation, you have to bend it like this, which kind of look odd. Otherwise, he doesn't have any knee. It's kind of weird. But, you know, he is a good-looking guy. So, Speed Lightning over there. Next up, let's go with the helicopter. This one had really bad instructions. But it's actually a really nice transformation and a really nice copter mode. All of this, the white and black right here, is all die-cast. Which is really nice. Give him, like, a really heavy front. So yeah, this one is called Dark Steel Armor. Now I don't know why Dark Steel Armor. He's not dark. Maybe he is made of steel, I don't know. But armor, I don't know. He's not the most armored guy on the whole team. So yeah, there's like three blades that spins a little bit, but otherwise not much to it. The back panel can open for I don't know, dropping stuff. So that's pretty much it. Transformation, you want to close down all the blades. You want to just separate the back panel right here, and you open these up. While you open these up, just be careful. It's the peg right here. It's kind of hard to do when it clips in. So yeah, just flip it and like this. You might want to make the blades go that way, which helps. The cannons, you want to flip them up temporarily and pull the cockpit. So yeah, the guns, they're like this. You want to pull them down and pull the whole assembly and clip it in. This is like the waste that moves in and out. So, yeah. And then you want to pull the legs even further. So it kind of looks like a weird bird, if you ask me. Then you come down here, and this is the crouch piece, and you flip it down. Next up, you separate the legs, like this. And you rotate the blue part right here all the way around. You flip this open, flip this open, and this is gonna make a foot. Same thing on the other side, flip it open, flip these open, and then you want to move the cannon back down, which kind of hides the opening right here, which is really nice. And now we have the legs done, and that's not a pretty good dirt walk mode, no? Sorry. Alright, next up you want to come right here and separate the whole tail right there. Open, well, these should be open anyway. And you want to move them down. And the legs are kinda hard. Alright, and then you want to move the wings up like this, well, the tail, and rotate the whole thing like this. And as you rotate, you bring the tail around. So it's like this. And then you take the tip of the tail and you flip it like this. As you flip it on itself, there's a square peg right here and a square peg and a square hole right there. You just, you know, 1 + 1. Do the same thing on the other side if it's not done. It's done automatically. And then you flip out his knife hands. He's got knife hands. He doesn't even have hands normal. He's just knife hands. And finally, you just flip the head open. Like this. And now we have dark steel armor. All robot mode. And he actually looks pretty nice. This one reminds me, the legs reminds me a lot of the Nut Ironhide from the Fire Truck Rescue Team. And the arms also kind of reminds me of him, like he's got blade arms also. Now articulation is he does have like rotation at the shoulder, swivel of the arms, double swivel like this. And he does have rotation at the blades and wrist thing. The head is on a tiny ball joint, which kind of go all the way around, and he does swivel a little bit so he can move back and forth. And as for the legs, also like a ball joint, but limited. No swivel at the thighs. He does have knee bend about 95 degrees, and only foot pivot. No side to side. And yeah, dark steel armor. Yeah, it actually is pretty cool. You can close these up, cover the let's put him aside. And oh boy, let's go with the Hummer. I'm gonna keep the boat for last. The Hummer, he's called, by Google Translation, he's called Ray Pluto. I don't know why, but I'm not asking a question. He's actually a nice, kind of heavy Humvee. Big wheels, all nice. Underneath, it's pretty nice. All of the back is all die-cast, which is really nice. He's quite hefty. And yeah, that's pretty much it. He's got some sort of missile launching right here, which kind of shoots straight into his own tires. Don't ask question. yeah, they kind of look like a Brawl from the Revenge. No, not yeah, the first Transformer movie. Like, you know the I don't know. So yeah, Ray Pluto. Transformation now. First you want to unlock the front wheels like this. Then you want to Kind of move the bumper down. Yeah, these are kind of clip in upside on the upper bumper. So you move these down. Then you want to kind of, kind of hard, but you need to move the bumper up like this, kind of like accordion it on the roof like this. And then you can open it up, but technically it just sits right there, so it's kind of flush with the hood. And next up, you want to open these. First one, you need to work around like this, and then you want to put the hood back. So now you have the doors opened up like this. As for the legs, you going down, flip these open, and continue to rotate them down. Now you just bend the knees a little bit, and you can see like right here, there's a white peg, and it's gonna clip over the kneecap. So you just clip it on, and it locks the knees inside. Then you want to come unbalanced here and flip the foot out like this. Flip the foot out like this, and now you have the legs done. Next up, you want to pull the waist down like this. And as you can see, there's a couple of tabs right here on my finger. You want to push them out, which kind of opens up the stomach. And finally, you just move the arms down, flip those around, and you kind of flip the bumper down and flip the hands. And yeah. So now we have the arms done. Do the same thing for the other side, flip it all the way around, twist it down, flip the wrist, and then you open up the head, reveal. It's kind of hard when you don't have any fingernails. Alright, I got it. And wait, before you open up the head, you want to open up these cannons right here, and then you can lift the head open. So now he has like head cannons. And there we have the Ray Pluto. Kinda looks weird. Just fiddle around. Yeah. Ray Pluto. His leg just unpegged right here. Alright. So we have Ray Pluto. And he's an okay guy, I guess. The head is on a swivel. It's kind of look nice. This one does have a light piping for some reason. I don't know why. All the other ones doesn't. Only him. He's got nice cannons. The arms are on a swivel right here. And a tight ball joint there. There's a swivel there and another ball joint right here. There's no waist articulation. There are some ball joints for the waist, and there's a knee bend that goes way past 95 degrees, 45 degrees, and the foot is on a ball joint, so there's a lot of motion there. So yeah, Ray Pluto. I don't know why they call him like this. It's just odd. And also, he's the tallest guy of the bunch. Now, first of all, I think this one is the weakest link of the gang, the boat. He kind of looks nice. He even had like wheels underneath, which is cool. So, you know, for a boat, can move around. But his name from Google Translation, I swear to God, this his name is Bingo Hunter Hunting Hunter. Swear to God. Bingo. Bingo Hunter Hunting Hunter. I'm gonna have a lot of problem with this.
Alright.
Now this one, the instructions are so bad. I still am not sure how to transform him legit. There's a lot of like these holes right there, like the square one, and then there's a wide one right here. I am sure they are meant for something, but for some reason, like, I don't know. I can't find it. The instructions are so bad. So yeah, for transformation, pull this like this, the back reactor. You want to unpeg this like this, unpeg like this, and then you want to pull, well, you want to open these window like this, and then you want to pull the leg out, which is really freaking hard, like this. I don't even think they're all pulled out anyway. Alright. Next up, you want to flip the toes. So now we have foot. Then you want to open up this. And open the flap right here. They're closed like this. You want to open these up. Flip these this around like this. And the instruction tells you to seriously leave like this, and yeah, open up the cannon hands. You can flip those around, and take the instruction seriously tells you to leave it like this, and to, you know, that's how you're supposed to be. There's like a huge gap right here, and I have no idea why, and it just sucks so bad. So, what I done is move these like this, just, you know, give them some clearance, and move those inside, and peg, well, not peg, but, you know, just close them like this. Close them like this, which kind of looks much better if you ask me. But yeah, the instruction doesn't tell you to swing that way. So yeah, articulation, there is some rotation here. The head is on a swivel, and if you look closely, that panel right here kind of snaps over here and kind of blocks his mouth a little bit. Kind of weird. So yeah, it does have like swivel here, swivel there, and a swivel at the elbow, and swivel there, and what we consider his wrists. He's got a lot of joints, you know. And as for the legs, he does have like a ball joint right here, a swivel there, which should be the knee. But yeah. Separate this, and finally the foot does have a swivel, but it's due to transformation. And yeah, here we have bingo, hunting. So here we have the whole lot of the gray of the crew, and they look pretty nice. I love them, but I gotta warn that the transformation for the Gestalt mode is somewhat kind of really floppy. I had lots of problems like trying to make him stand, because there is, especially in the legs, there's a lots of joints, and none of them are tight. Well, really tight. The ones that are really tight does hinders, and the other ones, it's just really weird and really messy. But once you get him to stand and all, he looks really nice. So, alright, if you want to start, let's move these one a little bit back. Oop, come on, stand. I said stand, god damn you. Alright, let's start with Pluto. It's easier to start from from track mode, but we'll start like this. So first you want to almost put his arms back into track mode, so like this, and you want to do the same thing on the other side, so like this. But then you move the arms back like this. You can close the fist in. The wheels opened up like this. The hood gonna be moving like this. The door closing back like this. Yeah. For now you can just leave it all of this. Yeah, to make it easier, let's just separate them in two. So close his stomach back in, flip the waist in, and move the leg down. Move the hood like this. Make sure the wheel is over the side door. This panel can, you can, the instructions say to leave it open. I prefer to leave it closed. It's my thing. Close the foot back in. And close the leg back in. Like so. As you close it, you may want to make sure to pull the bumper out just enough so the back panel clips into the peg right here. And then you just close the whole car, the whole panel like this. So now we have 1 foot. So the arm right here is gonna make a ankle tilt, footing. And finally, you see right here the orange light. You flip it open, and this is gonna be the connector. So we have one leg. We're just gonna have trouble standing, and we do the whole thing again on the other side. So close this. Close this, flip it this, this, flip this, close the whole body car, and there we have the other foot done, which the foot is kind of nice, and forgot to open up the connector. So now we have both legs done. Let's put this aside. And let's go with the police car. This one needs to go back completely into a car mode. Completely. Except for this one. You just push the head in, which makes the combiner head comes out. And that's it. All the rest is back into vehicle mode. So put the hands up. This, if I remember correctly, I haven't done this too often. And the legs, split the doors, flip the toes in. What the hell am I doing? Nope. Ah! The ball joint popped out. This, unpick this, all right, the doors like this, put this, close the whole door, close the back of the car mode, and the arms goes back in. Which is kind of floppy, like I said. Alright, and now you have to peg the whole thing in, which is, holy crap, I did it first time. I had so much trouble when I tried it first. So yeah, this is all we had, all we need. Technically, I think it's, well, this is all the instruction tells you to do it. I think it's bad, because it's just going to be like this. The shoulder is going to be right here, And the whole, this is a whole backpack, which kind of looks goofy. We'll get back to this later. The bike now. Phantom Pioneer. Basically, again, it's in a bike mode. So, flip these back. This. Close this. Close this. Take the wheels in. Well, as for the wheel right here, there's some claws in it. You want to open these up. All of them. Like this. And then you want to peg the legs. There's like three tiny holes inside the wheel. And you have to align all of the other ones. Which is really weird and hard to do when you can't see much. But, yeah. the head goes back in. Like this. You can move the handlebars up. Move the tank up. The seats are going to go back the way they were. Close the thumbs in. Like this. Rotate this in. Rotate this like this. Everything pegs back in. I'm trying to go as fast as I can without making too many mistakes. Alright, this looks nice. Alright, and as for the front wheel, you split it open and you move it like this. I kind of like to jam the handlebar inside of the wheel to make it whole. Like this. And finally, you just squeeze the whole thing back in the waist and move this like this. And there's like two square pegs right there and two square like this. You want to peg these in. It doesn't hold a lot at all, but yeah, it does the job. Want to move these on the side just for some clearance. And basically, we are done with the and you just flip the connector out like this, and that's it. We have one arm done. Let's go with the dark steel armor. So this one also had incredibly bad instructions. This one, I'm gonna show it. So first, close it. You just go back to helicopter mode, basically. So, the other way around, like this. Move the tail back up, like this. So we have the tail. Move it all the way around. Rotate it. Close it like this. And close it back in. Open the panel right there. Close it in. And peg everything together. And these blades like to pop out a lot. So, yeah. Basically, the instructions tells you to put the cockpit back in and plug it. You just open the connector right here. And, yeah. The instructions just tells you to put the arms like this. Well, technically, just imagine the cockpit like as the helicopter mode normally and just put it like this. And these were, I don't know, like fingers. It's goofy and ugly as hell. And you know what? They're wrong. Totally wrong. Because if you just move it all the way around like this, the toes acts as a fist. As you can see, a claw, like a grabbing arm. Which is actually pretty nice. And you just move this around and you have like an articulation right there. I don't know why the instruction just tells you to move the claw like this. It looks goofy as hell. So yeah, you have an arm like this with a claw if you just flip it around. And just to make it look less weird, you can just bend this You know, like transformation normally. Like this. Flip the knife around. Flip the knife around. So you have like a shoulder with a huge spike and the arm like this. It, which looks so nice. So you can also open up the tray lead. And yeah. This is the arm. This is the arm that I like. This is a fan mode. Well, I guess so. And yeah, the connector right here, and you can split the L back in. This just unpeg itself, I guess. Yeah. So yeah, it looks so nice. So we have another arm done. And now we're left with Bingo. Bingo Hunter, Hunting Hunter. Swear to God, I'm not making this up. This one is just odd, really odd. I get where they're going, but it's really weird. So basically you just put the arms like this, put the backpack reactor open in the back like this, close these back in like this. I'm going to close the all of this like this. So close this like this. Flip it all the way around. Close these. So basically, you just flip it around, and this is the waist and thighs, which is okay. Next up, you want to move one leg completely on this side and pull the window down like this. Then move the whole thing on the other side and take that with that window, bring it down and snap both of these together. Next up, you want to take the cannons and bring it in front. Take the cannons, bring it in front. Now it tells you to put the cannons straight up so that they shoot. But these are sloppy on the ball joints, so just tuck it in. Next up, you want to open these up completely, like this. Now that panel just stays there, I guess. You can open it up. This is the tricky part. So, close the feet. Like this. And right here on each leg, there's hooks. You want to pull those out. Like this. So just do the other side like this. So you have hooks, and then you bring the legs like this. And this is part of the torso. And we have all the parts made for combining. I get where they're going, and it's really original, but there's a lot of floppy parts, and yeah. Let's go and assemble the legs. So you want to take the T mushroom part and slide it in. Oops. Slide it in the leg right there and twist it like this. And it locks the leg in. So you do the same thing for the other side. And now we have legs done. And you just witness why one thing that doesn't hold a lot. And yeah, it's kind of getting really big right now. And you see, floppy mess. That connector part right here doesn't hold a lot. It just clips it in and doesn't hold a lot. And it's the same thing for both sides, which is it's a shame, you know? So now that he holds, move these like this, put this in the back. Well, maybe I want to move the camera a little bit up so you can see better. Alright, now these are like the instruction I tell you to. So you take the speed lightning dude, and there's some holes right there on each side of the hood. These are the going to be clipped in the hood, and underneath here there is a long peg. This is going to be pegged in here. So here, peg it in the center, and then you use the hook and you hold the car in place like this. So this is the whole body, but then if you turn around, it kind of looks really goofy, but yeah, I kind of like it. Make it a whole piece like this. Yeah, so now we have the upper bar body done, which is really back heavy. All right, as for the arms, you take the motorbike, and right here on the side, there's some giant holes. So you just peg it in, like so. And he does have like arm rotation. And you do, this is another thing, the hooks doesn't hook too bad, too good. And you take the other arms and peg it in, same thing. And now we have the combined load done. And does he hold? He holds. Which is a miracle all by itself, because he's super floppy. Let's just move the camera down a little bit so you can see all of him. Yeah, now we have the combined mode, and yeah, according to Google, he's named Swat Transformer Shock Attack Alloy Deformation City Defense. That's a mouthful. So yeah, he's actually looking really nice. He looks so good when you don't touch it, and when you can like pose him and just hope that nothing bad happens. Like I said, the arms look so good like this. You do have a thumb and a finger looking thing. Right here is the like a chainsaw and fingers claw clipping, which is kind of cool. Articulation wise, he does have like rotation in the arm. Does have like a joint right there. The head is on a weird swivel. It's not like hook on the base of the neck. It's hook at the back of the head, so we can flip the head. I'm just noticing you can't see anything, so move it. Right. So yeah, the head is not like hook at the base of the neck. It's hook at the back of the head, so you can, you know, do some really cool poses, I guess. The arms does rotate. And yeah, it's really freaking hard to make the whole thing hold these hooks. Yeah, he does have like a rotation in the arms. Again, on the other side, he does have like a rotation joint. As for the legs, he does have like a swivel right here. He does have a leg rotation. He does have some knee joint. There's a knee joint right here. There's a knee joint right here. There's a knee joint right there. There's so many joints. It all gets confused and it makes the whole thing sloppy. So yeah, he does look nice. He is imposing. He's slender. He looks muscular. Oops, the camera is not centered. He does look nice, but he is a pain to pose. Just for the fun of it, here's comparison size with his old buddy Transjet. I'm gonna put them here. He's actually a little bit small, a little bit smaller, and he is with the his other good buddy, the Fire Rescue Team, which I love. And yeah, you can see they fit really nice together. He kind of looks odd. He kind of looks big, bulky, and this one looks kind of slim, slender, you know, athletic, really nice. So yeah, do I recommend him? Absolutely. He is really nice if you don't play with him too much. He is a floppiness, yes, but you can all fix the joints easily with some glue or liquid plastic or varnish thing, you know, stuff that makes the whole joint tighter. Transformation for these guys is really awesome. The price, I think they cost me, it was like $80 for the whole set, plus shipping and handling and whatever. almost $100 with the shipping included, and it's really freaking awesome. Just gonna remove his buddies. Yeah, so he is absolutely amazing. He is cheap. He is original. He has less trouble like standing up. The instructions are horrendous, but he still looks amazing. And like I said, like the backpack is kind of weird. The whole thing, like in the back, like this. Gotta move the camera a little bit. The whole car going back looks odd as hell, but I'm gonna try and not explode anything. Okay, so yeah, his arms are just exploded. So you just take the speed lightning dude, and you just open the kind of like the transformation, like you open the hood like this, and you can clip it in like this, which actually looks much better. So let's try and do this without breaking anything. One joint. The side doors just really gets in the way. So yeah, it's better to just do it like this. So the door like this, the car like this, and the hell position. Alright, let's do this. Yeah. Now it clips in. Now you take the hooks like this. And the other one like this, and the backpack already looks much better. But yet again, he still has lots of problem with the joints not being stiff enough. Or don't fall. Yeah, he is still pretty cool. Lots of joints and, you know, locking mechanism that needs to be tweaked, but he is still an awesome figure. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed my review, and stay tuned for the next one. Thank you for watching. See you later.